Good morning, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to station number 20, where we are getting into the muscles of the lower limb. So we're going to start with anterior compartments. Specifically, we're going to start with the anterior thigh, and then we're actually going to see some of the medial thigh as well. So we're looking at a kind of slightly lateral view here. You can see a bit of the gluteus maximus, because I think it's rotated just a little bit lateral. And we're going to start with the sartorius muscle, which I'm going to outline real quickly here. And you kind of lose it after a moment from this view because it is heading quite medially. So it starts laterally. It's starting at this anterior superior iliac spine, kind of that end of the iliac crest region. And then it's going to extend all the way to the medial surface of the tibia. So this is a very long muscle. In fact, it is the longest muscle of the body. And I really want you to note here that it is quite superficial. It is kind of running over the quadriceps region. So it's in its, even though it's considered part of the anterior compartment, it is superficial to the quadriceps portion. Over here, just because we can see it, is a muscle you're not having to identify, but it is quite visible here, so I do want to point it out, which is the tensor fascia lati muscle. And it's this really short belly. It starts in the anterior superior iliac spine as well, and it will insert into the IT band, which is this very, very thick component of the deep fascia that you see on the lateral side of the thigh region. So similar, the gluteus maximus will also have most of its fibers inserting on the iliotibial tract as well. So that helps me when I can see the IT band, I know that this has to be lateral and this is going to be more medial. IT band is always lateral. Okay, focusing in on the quadriceps region, this is a superficial dissection, so we can only see three out of the four muscles. Running right down the middle will be the rectus femoris muscle, the one that is going to be the straight muscle. And then on either side, you'll have the vastus lateralis and medialis. So this is the lateral side, so this will be the vastus lateralis. And this is medial, making this the vastus medialis. And you can really see how these muscle bellies end, and then you get into that very thick quadriceps tendon. The patella would be right in this region, and from there on, you would have the patellar ligament. Okay, looking at a slightly deeper dissection, so same, there's that IT band again, so this is lateral, and this is medial. This has actually been cut at the pubic symphysis, so we know pubic symphysis is medial. And one of the dominant things that you can see in this image is this the large neurovasculature that is going to run deep in this region, which is the femoral neurovasculature. And I hope that you recall that the femoral nerve, which you can see a bit of right here, is really what is providing the motor innervation to the anterior compartment. And so that you can see it actually traversing this region along with the large femoral artery, and the femoral vein would also be here. Okay, so let's try to identify the iliopsoas, and if you recall from our lecture videos that the iliopsoas, you can see the muscle belly a lot easier from looking around the vertebral region or the pelvic region when they are the psoas major and the iliacus muscles, and this is psoas major right here. The iliacus, this is a bit of it right here. So they will combine to form the common tendon. So right around this region, you're getting into the iliopsoas. It's quite small in terms of being able to see its insertion, whereas it's not a small muscle at all. It's just when we get into the thigh region, it looks kind of small, but certainly not insignificant. You can see that the sartorius has been cut in this image in order to get a better view of this whole region. And then if we move back to the quadriceps region as well, the rectus femoris has been cut. That's what has been removed right here. And so again, you can still see the vastus lateralis and the vastus medialis, but you can also see the vastus intermedius because the rectus femoris has been removed. And so you would have to reflect or remove the rectus femoris in order to have a nice view of the vastus intermedius. And then lastly, let's look at what we can see in a slightly superficial dissection of the medial compartment of the thigh, or those adductors. So again, this is more that anterior compartment. You can see the rectus femoris right here. Sartorius has been cut. You can see a bit of the iliopsoas a little bit closer up. This is vastus medialis. And so over here, kind of being divided, here are the quadriceps. There's that femoral neurovasculature. That's the vein, artery, and nerve. Over here, kind of from here on, we are in that medial compartment, or the adductor compartment. And the most medial muscle in the adductor compartment is going to be the gracilis. And it is a very kind of strap-like muscle that will extend from the it'll extend from the pelvic region all the way down towards the tibia. So whatever is the most medial muscle in the thigh, think gracilis. And then when you're looking at a superficial dissection, really the only adductor muscle that you can see well is going to be the adductor longus, and that is this large muscle right here. The adductor longus is large, it's fan-shaped, it will occlude the view of the adductor brevis as well as the adductor magnus, which you can actually see better from a posterior view, but sometimes those hamstrings will kind of cover it. So we don't have adductor magnus on here, and it's not that it's not a large muscle, it's a very, very large muscle, but the majority of what we're looking at for our lab purposes are more superficial dissections, so it's actually occluded by a lot of muscles, but it's still a considerably large muscle and a very powerful adductor as well. All right, excellent. So that is the anterior and the medial thigh muscles. We will continue and to the next station, where we will continue our discussion of thigh muscles, but we will be looking at a posterior view. All right, thank you for your time and attention here, and as always, please feel free to reach out with any questions.